Today's video is brought to you by Empower. It's this app I've been using that can help you save and budget money. The best part, it's free. To download it, all you have to do is go to empower.me/companyman. The link is in the description. Before I start, I just want to say I'm not a scientist, and there's a lot of science involved in this video. I'll be talking about seismic reflection and transistors, microchips, and other science. It's all very surface level, and I'm sure you can understand why. Plus, the focus here isn't on the science, it's Texas Instruments, so keep that in mind. I just want to point out that what I'm doing here is unprecedented. 2 weeks ago, I talked about Best Buy, and then the following week, I talked about Dell, since Dell products are found inside Best Buy. Now, I thought I'd take it one step further and talk about Texas Instruments, because their products are found inside of Dell products. You see what I'm doing here? It just keeps getting deeper. I've labeled it Companyception, but this is the end. I wouldn't know where to go from here. That's why I thought it'd be cool to talk about them this week, but the reason I wanted to talk about them at all is because I feel that they don't get enough respect. When I say Texas Instruments, I'm guessing you think of calculators. I do. When I was in grade school, I had a TI-30. The TI stands for Texas Instruments, by the way. When I went to high school, I needed a graphing calculator, so I upgraded to the TI-84, even spent the extra few dollars to get the silver edition. I ended up using that calculator for the next 10 years. When it finally stopped working, I no longer needed any of the graphing features, but I still went out and bought a nearly identical TI-84 since I loved it so much and was so familiar with it. In my experience, these have always been the standard when it came to calculators. Sometimes in school you'd see someone with a Casio or some other brand, but they always regretted getting it. I mean, what are you doing? If you're in school and you have a Casio, at least once every class, the teacher would have to stop everything and try to figure out whatever the Casio equivalent of his instructions were. Nothing against Casio, but you were holding up the class. TI is what the teachers would recommend. It's the only brand I've ever owned, and I can confidently say I've never knowingly bought anything else made from Texas Instruments. And I'm guessing that's the case for many of the viewers as well, at least for Royal King Kyle, MVP Gaming, and Greg F. But I don't think we're giving them enough credit. Texas Instruments is not just calculators, and the sole purpose of this video is to prove it and show you that TI is, in fact, bigger than you know. For one, they didn't start by selling calculators. In fact, they started in 1930 and didn't sell a single calculator until the 1970s. So what were they doing during these 40 plus years? Well, changing the world is what they were doing. Are you familiar with seismic reflection? It's a way of detecting where there's oil under the ground. To my understanding, and it's done in a similar way in water, but on land, a giant truck starts pounding at the ground and creating all these sound waves, and then those waves make their way underground and then reflect back. And there's a bunch of devices laid out across the ground capturing these reflections, and I suppose based on these results, the scientists can tell whether or not there was oil down there reflecting the sound waves. There's been a lot of oil found using this method, and it appears that even today, this is the most common way of doing it. Now, if there's any geophysicist out there, I'm sure you can explain reflection seismology and its significance a little better than me, but my impression is that this method completely changed the game. The person who invented this method is named Dr. J. Clarence Karcher. In 1930, he teamed up with another geophysicist named Eugene McDermott to start a company called Geophysical Service, and they would further research and develop the technique, but also manufacture equipment for it. By 1941, the structure of the company was a little different, and it allowed McDermott to get together with a couple of employees to buy it, which ended Karcher's involvement. World War II created the need for some electronic equipment, such as radar systems, that weren't too much of a stretch for the company to produce. They began producing them for the US military during the war, and continued doing it afterward as well. This pushed them towards starting an electronics division in addition to their oil exploration. In the 1950s is when the company we know today started taking shape. The electronics division was a big success and was becoming their main focus. In 1951, the decision was made to reorganize and change the name to Texas Instruments, while Geophysical Service would become a subsidiary. So from this point, forget the oil. They were now mostly concerned with electronics. 2 years later, Texas Instruments became a public company. Now, here's some more science. Transistors. Do you know much about these? Because they're arguably one of the most important inventions ever made. Evidently, there's 2 billion of them in a smartphone, and we wouldn't even have computers or smartphones that aren't thousands of pounds without them. See, computers used to be massive and take up an absurd amount of energy because they use these big vacuum tubes that have since been replaced by transistors. Again, if there's any scientist that can add more to the transistor semiconductor discussion, please feel free. But Texas Instruments has benefited greatly from these over the years and was part of the industry from very early on. In 1952, the germanium transistor was a new thing, and they obtained a license to manufacture it, and it ended up becoming a big part of their business over the next couple of years. But as it turns out, germanium isn't the best element for these transistors. It doesn't work well under heat, and there's other reasons, but silicon is a much better material. In 1954, Gordon Teal, a scientist working for Texas Instruments, developed the first commercially produced silicon transistor. Remember how transistors changed the world as we know it, and how silicon transistors are the best transistors? Wouldn't you think being the first company to mass produce these things would be a big thing for them? Because it was. This was the thing that put Texas Instruments on the map. This here is from PBS. It's referring to the moment they introduced the silicon transistor. They say, "That moment catapulted TI from a small startup electronics company into a major player. They were the first company to produce silicon transistors, and consequently, the first company to produce a truly consistent mass-produced transistor." In 1957, they made a deal with IBM that made them a major component supplier for their computers. Just to show how much all of this did for them, their sales in 1952, mostly before they entered the market of semiconductors, were $20 million. By 1956, they had more than doubled to $46 million. And by 1958, they doubled again to $92 million. Now, to go along with these transistors, Texas Instruments is also responsible for the first microchip, or integrated circuit, invented in 1958. Jack Kilby was the guy behind it. Again, this was a big invention. It's the thing that makes computers and smartphones and the internet all possible. It made use of the newly invented transistors and just allowed everything to be much smaller and more compact. Again, any scientist or computer enthusiast watching this can provide more specifics, but I think we can say it changed life as we know it. By 1969, the microchips had become cheaper and more perfected, and IBM started using them in all of their computers. And just an aside, last year, that very first one was up for auction for $600,000. So I think we can agree that Texas Instruments was not built on calculators, but they did invent the single chip microprocessor that made small, inexpensive calculators possible. They invented it in 1970, and in 1972, they sold their first calculators, and throughout the 70s, calculators blew up in popularity. But it was never the core of their business. At this point, it was already these transistors and semiconductors, and that hasn't changed either. Now, there's so much more that can be said about their innovations and contributions to computing, but since we've reached the calculator age, I think that's a good time to skip ahead to today. Looking at the company today, here's what they say their business is. They say, "We design and make semiconductors that we sell to electronics designers and manufacturers all over the world." That's the core of their business, but they do have a lot going on. They make amplifiers, data converters, processors, sensors, switches, and multiplexers, a bunch of stuff only an engineer would understand what it is. They're on the stock market, valued at almost $100 billion. Their sales last year were almost $15 billion, which places them at number 192 on the Fortune 500 list. And here's where that $15 billion came from. 35% was categorized as industrial, 19% was automotive, 25% was personal electronics, 12% was communications equipment, 6% was enterprise systems, and only 3% was categorized as calculators and other. It gets lumped in with it. So at a maximum, 3% of their sales were from calculators. Let me know in the comments, did you underestimate Texas Instruments? I suppose they're most known for their calculators because that's the only way the general public knowingly comes in contact with them. But I thought it was important to look at the rest of their business since it's most of their business. Plus, overall, It's an impressive company, isn't it? I mean, they've helped change the world as we know it through their silicon transistors and microchips and calculators and even oil detection techniques. There is so much more to be said about this company, but the intention of this video was to try to show a side of it that I don't think many of us knew, and I hope it did that. So if you have any thoughts on Texas Instruments or have anything scientific to add to the discussion, please leave it in the comments. I'd like to hear what you have to say. Today's sponsor is Empower, and I love talking about Empower because there's so much to talk about. Once you download it, link it to your bank account, which you should feel safe about. It uses bank-grade security. We're talking 256-bit SSL end-to-end encryption and multi-factor authentication. And then go down to the monthly report. It's a visual breakdown of what you're spending. What you hope to see here is that you're spending too much on travel or shopping. Those should be fairly easy to manage. And Empower has ways to help you do that, by the way. But what you may find is that you're spending too much on housing. Fixing that may take some major changes, but I'd say that's an important thing to know. So if you find you need some extra help with your finances, there's Empower experts available. They'll listen to your issue and provide suggestions on ways you can improve. It'll look for savings in everyday transactions like your cable bill or insurance plan. In fact, the average user saves $285 by renegotiating their bills and $460 by switching to a cheaper insurance plan. I advise that you check it out. Just look through it and see how it can help you. Simply go to empower.me/companyman to get your free account and start saving today. Thank you for watching.